In this tutorial, we will explore what sorts of data related to devices and subscribers that the Device Manager ACS is capable of storing and retrieving, and where you can access this information. In the banner across the top of the account window, the leftmost box provides some key information regarding the subscriber. The adjacent box provides key information regarding the gateway. Expand the Device Management drop-down at the left sidebar and choose Gateway Information. Let's see what's here. The device identification information, including manufacturer, model, and serial number. Device details, including firmware version, WAN type, and external IP address. Device labels. Those appear up here and in other places. We'll discuss labels at length in another tutorial. Bulk operations are also discussed in detail in another tutorial. Excluding a particular device from bulk operations is possible, however the need for this is rare. This box is usually left checked. If your infrastructure requires them, you can set PPP credentials here. Here you have the means to delete the device record altogether, which permanently removes this device from Device Manager. The domain feature may or may not be present in your system. Domains provide a means to divide up your customer base among your support staff. In this example, the domains are simply named 1, 2, and 3. Customer support staff assigned to domain 1 can only see and interact with customers also assigned to domain 1. Domain 1 agents would have no visibility to and would not be able to assist customers in domains 2 or 3. Remove association. As it says here, this breaks the link between the device record and the subscriber record. The use of this feature is discussed in Part 3 of the tutorial series on provisioning. Back to the Device Management section on the left, let's explore what features and information are available under Subscriber Information. Note that most of these data fields being discussed are searchable when attempting to locate an account record. Be sure to look up Search in our knowledge base for more information. Also, watch the tutorial on provisioning to learn more about getting this data input into Device Manager. At the top appears the subscriber identification information, consisting of their subscriber code, which is essentially a customer number, the subscriber's name, and email address. Next appears the login information for the subscriber control panel. You have the ability here to also disable the control panel login for any customer. Next we have customer address information. It may have been manually entered, imported, or automatically moved in, perhaps via an API integration with an order entry system. More addresses could be added for other locations. Subscriber phone number is next. Just as above, additional phone numbers may be added for optional locations. The feature to delete the subscriber record permanently is here. This completely removes all data about this particular subscriber from Device Manager. Labels, as I mentioned, are discussed at length in a different tutorial. For now, note that labels can be applied to devices as well as subscribers. This is just a glimpse of where things live. We'll discuss these features further in other Device Manager video tutorials.